thermal expansion, the actual reason why most matter expands when heated. Temperature is a measure of how fast atoms and molecules move within a substance. If the average molecules are moving faster, it has a higher temperature. Okay, so let's look at a substance again. We're going to heat it up, and of course it's going to undergo a thermal expansion as most materials do. And let's zoom in on it and have a look at the particles. And in particular, let's have a look at two particles and their relation with each other. The force of neighboring atoms in a solid can be thought of as a system of springs. When the atoms are farther apart, the atomic force pulls them together. When they are close, the force pushes them apart. Thus, we have oscillating spring behaving system. Heating the substance will add more kinetic energy and thus increase the amplitude of this oscillating spring system. But it's a common misconception that a bigger amplitude is the reason for the thermal expansion. Let's see why a bigger amplitude doesn't cause thermal expansion. So let's compare a substance with different temperature, and keep in mind this is the wrong image, it's not correct. So the purple would represent a substance with a lower temperature, and the green will represent molecules with a higher temperature. You can clearly see that it has a bigger amplitude, it has a bigger reach than the purple. But you should also see that the green uses just as much time being compressed than stretched. So the average difference in expansion in this picture would be zero, because just as much time is being spent on being big, it is also spent on being smaller compared to the purple substance, the cold substance. Thus, the overall expansion is zero. The actual reason why matter expands has to do with these atomic forces. They are not symmetric. It takes more energy to compress the spring than it takes to stretch it. So on average, all the molecules would be more stretched than compressed. For a better physical explanation, we can go back and take a look at the oscillations again. For the first setup, where it took just as much energy to compress the string than to stretch it, it's a good approximation for smaller energies. But when there's more kinetic energy in the system, the spring, as we just concluded, takes more energy to compress than to stretch. And this is shown in the Morse potential. Here, on a graph, we see that the potential energy decreases because it takes more force to compress it than to stretch it. To maintain the total energy, the kinetic plus the potential, the atomic force will have more kinetic energy when stretched, and therefore the average distance between them increases. Okay, just to round things off, let's take a look at this potential energy graph once again. When we see the mechanical energy, that is the potential energy, the potential to do work, and the kinetic energy, you know that one, of course the kinetic energy is greatest at the equilibrium position, and the potential is greatest on the sides. Notice here when we have the Morse potential, when it reaches the left side, it's much harder to compress, and therefore it reaches a much greater potential. On the right side, it's way easier to stretch, and therefore the force isn't all going to the potential energy, but there's always some kinetic energy compared with the simplified model.